Hello everyone. On our week 9 lesson, we will talk about the concept of faith in the comparative religion. So beginning with the faith in shamanism. So as my introduction, every person on the planet has a belief, a religion. So even if a person does not believe in God, he has a religion of his own, because when we speak of religion, it has a belief. So even if he don't believe in God, that is still a belief. Okay, so short historical background of shamanism. Shamanism originated among hunting and gathering cultures and persisted within some herding and farming societies. So dugay na ni kayo ni nga kuan, one of the oldest religion ni ang shamanism, no? So there are place nga nagparticularly nag originate siya, no? So in a separate video, kanang complementary video, mag provide ko sa inyo for us to have a better understanding of this religion of shamanism. So shamanism, as I have said, shamanism is one of the oldest belief system in the world and can be found today in many tribal communities in many places around the world. So there are, even here in the Philippines, we have some influence about this belief, no? So there are a lot of people who practice this kind of belief. Okay, in this religion, although they call themselves as non-literate religion, meaning they don't have any formal documents or writings about their beliefs, but they have this leader that they call shaman. So what is the role of a shaman? So in their screen, you will find that there are roles of a shaman. Number one, he is a healer. So a shaman is a warrior who combat disease. He acts as a medicine man. Number two, he is also an educator. He is a keeper of myth and traditions. Number three, he is also a war chief. He is a ruler of the tribe. So whatever he or she said is followed by the communities. So unsa may mga unsaon man nga mahimong shaman, so na calling pud ni siya, no? Calling ni siya nya. Pwede lalaki, pwede pud babae. Okay? So what are the beliefs of shamanism? So shamanism rests for its basis on the animistic view of nature. So animism teaches that primitive and savage man views the world as pervaded by spiritual forces. So ang pasabot ani, ang mga tao nga naga-believe sa shamanism kay they believe nga naay mga spirits nga naa sa atong palibot, naa sa kalibutan, no? Mga spiritual forces. Kita, di taga kita nila, pero sila, makita na sila sa tua. Okay? So, kinsa may naay kakayahan makipag-communicate ani mga spiritual forces, ang katong mga gitawag na shaman. Okay? In conclusion, if we try to conceptualize shamanism, it is just pertain to beliefs in terms of communication to the spiritual world. And the trust is in the shaman, not in the spirit. So unsay kalahian ani sa ato ang religion, no? Let's start to talk about ang similarities, no? Ang shaman, ang equivalent ana sa ato ang mga Christians kay pari or pastor, na dayon ang ilahang role kay similar kayo kay mura sila ag mediator, nagamediate, no? So pari, pastor, mediator, instrument of God, ang kaning shaman, mediator gyapon ni sila between the physical world and the spiritual world. thinking. Now, ang ilahang concept sa God is lahi kaysa sa ato, kay kita, we will be able to have a tanabang personal relationship with God. Pero sa ilaha, ang ilahang gituhuan is more on the shaman rather than the spirit. So, murag mas na sila personal nga relation sa shaman kaysa sa katong spirit or God. So, mo na nga itong mga kalahian, ano, yung mga pipila nga kalahian sa itong religion o sa ilahang religion. So, napoy, na-similarities napoy kalahian. So, I will provide a complimentary video kay limited man po na ito ang kuan resources. So, outsource ko gikan sa YouTube kay para mas masabtan pa nato ni nga religion. Okay? So, please watch the supplementary video nga akong i-upload po sa Edmodo. So, that's all and thank you for listening.